the divisional officer for Manyu Central Subdivision, the Lord Mayor of Manyu Council, His Lordship, the Bishop of Manyu Diocese, the representatives of MIVA, One Man and Kameko, the Chairman of the Board of Manyu Community Radio, the traditional rulers, ladies and gentlemen, I could not miss this event. I am very proud to be the one standing today to preside over the inauguration of Manyu Community Radio. I'm happy because the event that we are witnessing today is the crowning of a long process, a process that took many years, a process which could end poorly, but which thanks to the collaboration of all the partners and the involvement of administrative authorities is concluded today. Manyu Community Radio Media Center and so on is a vast project that started many years ago, sponsored by MIVA One Man, which is a Catholic association based in the Netherlands that intervenes in such projects to facilitate and help people all around the world to improve their welfare. And when this project started, we had 7 associations in Manyu that were involved. But along the line, there were so many discussions. But I want to say that this project, in the mind of those who came to bring it, to bring the equipment that we are seeing and witnessing today, in their mind, it was an assistance brought to the Manyu population. An assistance brought to the Manyu population so that they would not be isolated in terms of radio communication, so that information would circulate all around the division and help people to be educated, to know what is happening all around them, and even in their own milieu. I personally, as SDO of this division, as it has been said by the well-renowned journalist of Manyu Extraction, Mr. Robert Abuno, when we went to Akwaya last Friday, we had a worry. The minister informed us of his arrival on Tuesday, and on Thursday he was already here in the division. And as we were going on Friday on helicopter, the question was to know, will the population of Tinta, who are the ones interested in this program, attend the ceremony? Fortunately, when we reached there, the Tinta population were there. And how were they there? It is because when I sent the information, the communique on Manyu Community Radio on Thursday, they blog published it. They heard it at Tinta, and they rushed to Akwaya. Unfortunately, that day, I had in the helicopter one of the animators of Manyu Community Radio. This to say that even we, as administrators, we are beneficiaries of that project. Wow. I should have said that things started with 7 associations, but along the line there were others. It is to say that whether we had seven associations or one or two or three, this project did come for seven associations. It did not come for one association, it came for Manyu population. And that's why the chairman of the board of directors of NIVA really said that he is expecting the population to organize themselves so as to have a board that will be managed, a board that will be representative of all the ranges of Manyu community. That will be managing it. Have a club of listeners that will support it so that from the beginning to the end, it remains a Manyu population affair. So, ladies and gentlemen, I want to draw your attention on something very important. Here you have people who are not Cameroonian, who are not from your families, who have no interest in your own business, and who have no company, no investment in Cameroon. The people who have gathered money from citizens of goodwill of their country to come and bring us this marvelous gift of more than 300 million CFA. We must show our gratitude by organizing ourselves, handling that marvelous gift the best way, so that tomorrow they will always hear in Netherlands how those things are happening very well in Cameroon.